Well, all right. Good morning, Cooper City Church of God. Are you happy to be here? Are you happy to be here worshiping in the house of God with fellow believers, mostly? But yeah, I'm glad. There's no other place on planet Earth I'd rather be than right here today with you guys, connecting with you guys, worshiping with you guys. Have you had a good time so far? Have you had a good time? I know it's a little different kind of church service, but this was a heart of Pastor Kevin and Pastor Michael and myself. We collaborated to start the VBX experience so that all the families could come, young and old and oldish, and just have a great time. And some of you were, raise your hand if you were at one of our VBX nights. You were here, yeah. So those of you that were not here, it was this past Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Those of you, we're having a special prayer vigil for you on the other side of the auditorium. We're going to pray for you so that next year, next year, make it out. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter if you don't have kids. So you just come and show up and have fun. Everybody had an amazing time, and I know I did. It was just amazing. Coming out of COVID and not being able to gather together and just to come and just have all the energy that you guys had, man, it was awesome. So I want to recognize this morning, before I get started, all of those that helped put that together, all of the leaders and all of our ministry heroes and so many people. But give them a big hand clap for all those who helped out. Miss Marcia and Linda and Pastor Ethan and Pastor Michael and myself. And we just want to thank you all. And I wish I could give you all a $20 Starbucks gift card, but it's not in the budget. I'm sorry. We spent it all on Pumbaa. So that warthog can eat, yo. Okay. So, yeah. So listen, real quick, I just want to spend a couple minutes talking to you. Obviously, we got our theme for VBX from a certain movie. Right? Do you know what it is, Sayla? Lion King, right? Right. So first service I asked, is there anybody in here that has not seen The Lion King? And I won't call you out. I won't judge you. Anybody not seen The Lion King? Because I told Craig I wouldn't call him out again second service. There was somebody that hasn't seen The Lion King? Pastor Crick, I know he's seen it. Oh, you haven't seen The Lion King? Shame on you. Do you not love Jesus? Shame. So for you, we're going to have to do some closed captions and stuff, so you're going to have to understand. When you leave here, please go see The Lion King, because there's really some amazing spiritual elements in The Lion King. And we just chose a couple to share with you this morning. So we're going to dive right into it. Is that good? Are we good? Everybody awake, alert? Ready to hear some word of God? All right. So four things we learned from the Lion King movie. Actually, there's more, like I said, but we're going to stick to these. So the first is we are all part of the circle. Tasia came up here and sang The Circle of Life, and I'm not going to lie. Like, I had this vision in my head of how that song was going to go this morning, and I'm not going to lie, man. I ain't going to front. I got a little choked up. Pastor Vince got a little misty-eyed this morning. It was so good. It was so beautiful. But we're all part of the circle of life. In Ecclesiastes, we read, "What do people get for all their hard work under the sun? Generations come and generations go, but the earth never changes. The sun rises, the sun sets, and then hurries up and rises again." The circle of life is kind of symbolic. It's a symbolic term for the series of events that happens on earth naturally. It has to happen. Right? This circle has to happen, right? Birth, life, death. And here in The Lion King, it refers to how events repeat themselves. Mufasa was a big lion in the movie that was the king, right? Okay, he was the king. I'm going to keep you up. But he was the king, right? So Mufasa... Don't send me an email. It's just for fun. This next generation, we get away with this. So Mufasa tells Simba that they are all part of the circle of life. Simba's born, he'll grow up, become king. And then he'll have a son who will grow up to become king, right? We all have that destiny or calling on our lives. So what we do with this time that we're given in this circle matters. It matters. What you do matters. What you do on planet Earth while you're here matters. You may not think it does, but the simplest thing matters. The simplest thing, coming to church, letting somebody see you, smile or give a fist bump or elbow or a high five, whatever, it matters. You would not believe it. You would not believe it. There have been times where we have been in churches visiting or whatever, and people get up and they leave, and like it's just like, I'm going to go eat. Time to go to eat. Mm-hmm. In Ohio, it was everybody go to like Bob Evans. Bob Evans or Perkins. Anybody hear Bob Evans or Perkins, those restaurants? That's where all the church people went. And but nobody would talk to each other. They'd walk out of the church. Music be playing. Yeah, let's just go. We got to focus, man. It's time to eat. But a smile, a handshake, just a... That matters. That makes such a big difference. You just have no idea. It's just amazing. Now, the second thing is balance. Everybody say balance. Balance. You guys are so much better than first service. This whole side didn't say it. Only this side did. Let's try it again. Everybody say balance.
Balance.
I like you guys. So, balance. Mufasa told Simba, again, Mufasa is the king, Simba is the son. Mufasa told Simba that everything you see exists together in a delicate balance. And as king, that he would need to understand that balance and respect all the creatures, from crawling ant to the leaping antelope. There is no greater lesson to teach than that of treating others with kindness and respect. In Luke, we read, do to others as you would like them to do to you. If you love only those who love you, why should you get credit for that? Because even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to only those who do good to you, why should you get credit for that? And if you lend money to those who lend money to you, what's the big deal? Give and it shall be given. Love your enemies. Ouch. God, really? Do you really want that? Love your enemies. Do good to them. Lend without expecting to be repaid. So, I don't know if anybody wants to follow scriptures this morning, but I'll be up here if you want to lend without wanting to get repaid. No, I'm just kidding. Then your reward from heaven will be great. And here's the line, man. You will truly be acting as children of the Most High. I want you to hear that. Hold that in, keep that in your hand. Children of the Most High. Keep that. Because we're going to circle back to that. Ooh, man. We're going to come back to that. That. I didn't mean to say that. You must be compassionate, just as your Father is compassionate. Simba learned that everything had a balance to it, right? Just like the balancing buckets we're going to use in a little bit for the offering. They're very, I mean, just one little washer makes a big difference. Everything has a balance. Now, when his uncle Scar was the king's brother, right? And so Scar took over. And those of you that watched the movie, you know he didn't respect that balance, right? He didn't respect the way that things went. And what happened? All of the animals ended up leaving, and the trees withered, and the place looked like a wasteland. All because he didn't respect the balance. He didn't care because it was all about him.
Well, I'm the king now, so I get what I want.
Never gave. And those of you that have seen the movie, you know that it eventually was just from a flourishing, vibrant, beautiful place to nothing. A place you just don't even want to go through. You don't even want to look at. Dry, disgusting, dirty. So respect the balance of life, love each other, and respect each other, even if you don't agree with them. That's the big one. Keep the balance. I had a great example of this. I'm going to tell you real quick. I'm going to be a little transparent with you this morning. Is that okay? Thank you, my friend. All right, I got a fan, one fan over there. He got a Pastor Vince sign. But so my daughter and I going to Starbucks. We come pulling up, and the way that the drive-thru is set up, you can come from three different ways, right? So we came from this way. We had the right-of-way to turn right. Well, this lady came from this way to turn left into the drive. We had the right-of-way. I'm just saying, don't get between me and my coffee. It ain't going to be pretty. Now, I'm a pastor. I love Jesus, but don't get in front of my coffee. So this lady pulls in front of us, and me and Lindsay, we both like, can you believe that? Are you serious, lady? What, you got a Mercedes that you should get to go first? You know, we're at all, okay. You know, this Jeep ain't good enough for you, you know. Can you believe this lady and the gall and the nerve she has? And we're just, like, chattering. And this is a real God moment. We get up to the cashier, and she goes, hey, the lady that was in front of you felt bad for cutting you off, and she wanted to pay for your stuff. I said, the food too? She said, yeah, she paid for your whole order. She said she's sorry. And I'm like, okay. Yeah. And then we left, and like me and Lindsay didn't say anything till we got back to the house. Not a word to each other. We just like holding this food that I didn't even want to eat or drink now. And we get back to the house, and I said, well, I guess we learned that lesson. I guess God taught us that one, right? And so I went through the drive-thru the other day when I was coming to church, and I kind of did the same thing because the Starbucks down here has got a weird drive-thru, and I kind of did the same thing. I'm like, I'm getting there first. And I got there first, and instantly, the Holy Spirit convicted me. And I'm like, oh. And I'm looking behind, and it's a lady with a little girl. And I'm like, oh. Man, so I get up to the register, and I got my app, and I scan it, and then I go, I kind of cut that lady off. I kind of was, like, in a hurry, and I feel bad, and how much is her order? And she said, it's $14. Can I pay half? $14, and I'm like, what'd she get? A coffee's $5. I said, no, you know what? No. Here, I want to pay for it. And like, really? Are you serious? Like, was so surprised that I wanted to buy that coffee. $14 here. And I felt, and I said, thank you so much. Man, you're such a nice person. God bless you. And I'm like, no, God bless you. I'm a pastor. You don't bless me. I bless you. But he blessed me. He said, God bless you. And I went on and came, and I was like, you know, thank you, God. Thank you for teaching me to have that balance. You know, little cup of coffee, man, probably just made that lady's day. You know, it's the craziest thing. It just, and people appreciate it. People appreciate it so much. Linda and I were at Winn-Dixie, and we were going through the thing and check out, and the lady on the other side of us, like, did her card, and she still owed, like, $3. And so we're cashing out, and I hear her. She's like, I'm going to go, you know, out. And so she left all her groceries, and she's going out to her car to scrounge for change. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, this is an easy one, God. Thank you for that. This ain't $14. Thank you, God. And Linda's like, get out of the way here. Here's $3. She just put it on, you know. And it was amazing. And it's something she might never remember. She didn't know us. She left, and we left. But those little moments help keep balance when we show love, not hate. Not anger, not bitterness, when we show compassion and love. My favorite. Are you ready? Number 3. Remember who you are. And remember whose you are. Right? Mufasa told Simba, when he spoke to him, Simba, remember who you are. You're my son, and you're the king. In 1 Peter, we read, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession. Think about that. You are God's special possession. Point to your neighbor and say, you're a special possession. You are God's special possession. It may not feel like it sometimes, and you might not think you are. Your self-worth might not be there, but you are. You are God's special possession. It's true. It's in the Word. That you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Simba forgot that he was the true king and heir to the throne. And it took him, now watch this, it took him having a moment with his father to be reminded of who he was. You remember that moment, right? He went away and then he saw this vision of his dad in the clouds. You know, the king, Mufasa, Mufasa. And his dad, Simba, remember who you are. You're my son and the true king. Nothing else mattered. Nothing that Simba had done. He didn't say, Simba, you shouldn't have been messing around with the warthog and the, this Jeffrey the giraffe, but and you shouldn't have been messing around and like being lazy all day and eating grubs. You know, he didn't say none of that. He just said, remember who you are. No matter where you go in life, no matter what you do, God is still there. Like Simba, have that moment with the Father. Sometimes that's just what we need. We need to be like the Lion King and have that moment with the Father and let him say, child, remember who you are. You are royal priesthood. You are my child. You are kings and queens, and you are royalty, and you are special to me. Have that moment with the Father to be reminded of who you are, who we are in Jesus. We are his, and we need to act like it. We need to act like it. We not be timid, but we need to proclaim the gospel wherever we go. Those moments with God are precious. When we are in Christ, we are his royal priesthood, a chosen people. And like Simba, it's in our bloodline. Mufasa's bloodline was Simba, and then Simba's son. So that royalty is in that bloodline. You and I have that same royalty in our bloodline. When you, no matter what you did, no matter where you came from, once you accept Jesus as your personal Savior and he is in your life, you get a blood transfusion. You get a new set of blood coursing through your body that is royalty. Everybody say royalty. You are royals. You now are a different person. And the blood you have is precious because it is from Jesus. Because he died on the cross, shed that blood, and it now runs in your veins. It's all about Jesus. Now, the last, it's a lesson that we learn from the Lion King. And our theme for this week, Hakuna Matata, right? Hakuna Matata. Now, we use Philippians 4:6 for our main thing, but I want to read from Matthew. I want you to hear this. This is why I tell you not to worry about everyday life, whether you have enough food and drink and enough clothes to wear. Isn't life more than food and your body more than clothing? Look at the birds. They don't plant or harvest or store food in the barns. For your heavenly Father feeds them. Now, aren't you more valuable than them? Can all your worries add to a single moment of your life? And why worry about your clothing? Look at the lilies of the field and how they grow. They don't work or make clothing, yet Solomon in all his glory was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for wildflowers that are here today and thrown into the fire tomorrow, he will certainly care for you. Why do you have so little faith? So don't worry about these things. Don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will bring its own worries. Today's trouble enough for today. Simba had the no-worry attitude, but he had it without respect, without the balance, without accountability. And he soon learned that he had a responsibility, and he went back. He went back to face his situations head on. We need to know that we will always have problems. We will always have troubles. But don't worry. Jesus has overcome the world. Let me say that again. Jesus has overcome the world. He has overcome sin and death. Worrying will never change your situation one bit. It won't. Here we go. Simple phrase. I didn't make it up, but I love it. Let go and let God. Everybody say, let go and let God. Let go and let God. So I want to see if we're tracking this morning. And during our VBX, we always do something a little different, a little weird. So I want to do an illustration this morning. All right? So I'm going to need 11 people to come up on stage real quick. I'm not going to make you talk. I'm just going to make you hold a card. Oh, thank you. Yes, you guys missed the first service, so you come on up. And bring Christina and Grace with you. All right, give them a hand clap. Let them feel like, you know. All right, my man, come on up. Don't duck your head. I saw you. Come on. Yes, your daughter got up here and danced. You're going to come up here as well. Come on. All right, here we go. Oh, Maddie, come on down, all the way down. Pastor Eric, yes, you and your lovely wife have to come down. Oh, my goodness gracious. All right. You see, I think she was all the way at the top. She's going to hate me later. Balance, love me, balance. All right, here we go. How many we got? Just stand anywhere. It doesn't matter. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pastor Bailey, you and your lovely wife, come on down. Sorry. You showed up, bro. That's what happens. And Miss Michelle, come on down. Oh. Sorry. Hey, it's the next-gen service, man. We can get away with this stuff. It's for the kids. It's for Jesus. That's why we do these things. You know, it's because Pastor Kevin and I was sitting one time and we were talking and he came up with that statement that we will do, Cooper City Church of God, we will do whatever it takes without sinning to reach the lost, to reach the next generation. So yeah, we're going to do a skit. We're going to do a dance or whatever. We're going to do these things to make sure these young people know that it's okay to have joy and love God and come to church and have fun. Have fun, smiling, leaving, going, yeah, hey, this is a good service. Yeah, amen, amen. So that's what we want. We want to put a smile on your face in Jesus' name. How many we got? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. All right. Now, I did this first service, and I was very scared. Pray for me this service. Just hold that. Don't show it. Hold that. Don't show it. Do I have to say it? Don't show it. I said, don't show it. Don't, why are you looking at it, bro? That's what you get for coming. All right. All right. Okay. Here, we'll see if this works. All right. So we have 11 cards, and we're going to see. I'm going to have somebody in the audience. I'm going to have you pick a number, and we're going to see if you can mentally pick the right card that will show us the answer. Okay, so Dr. Bailey, go ahead and turn your card around. Let's see what you got. You can do it slower, yeah. Dramatic effect, the key, and what do you got? What is it? The Bible. Okay, so hold those cards. Show them. Show them. You had to bring your phone. What are you going? You got a TikTok that you're waiting on? I mean, what's going on there? All right, so we're going to see today if somebody out here can choose what the Bible says that the key that what or who is the key to Hakuna Matata, to heaven, no worries. What is it in our life that we need to have joy, peace, love, balance, no worries? All right, so I need somebody to pick me a number. I need somebody that's not afraid to come stand right here. You're shaking your head. She's out there going, nope, nope, don't even. Pastor Vince, I will cut you. All right. All right. Who we got? All right. Here we go. Oh, no, no, no. Yeah, got, yeah, right here. Black shirt. Yeah, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. It ain't going to hurt. I promise. It ain't going to hurt. All right. Oh, hey, I didn't recognize you. Do you still go to church here? What's up? All right, come here. What's your name? How old are you?
I'm Jasmine, and I'm 12.
12. How long you been coming to church here?
I don't know.
That means a long time. I didn't even recognize you, man. You got so tall. All right, so, Chessman, I need you to... Well, he's sitting down. Were you tired already? You just got up. I need you to give me a number between 1 and 10. 1 and 10, okay? So, come on. I want you to look at the cards, and I want you to mentally give me a number between 1 and 10.
5.
Okay, I want you to look at the cards, and I want you to mentally give me a number between... No, I'm just kidding. 5's your number? That's your final answer? That's your final answer, 5. You sure? You know, because the person in the first service... Okay, 5 it is, 5 it is. Okay. Oh, okay, so we're going to make this even harder. How do you spell 5?
F-I.
Did you see how he hesitated? You better be checking that homework.
F-I-V-E.
F-I. Someone's clapping. Someone's clapping. We're proud of you. All right. Spell it out. F. F-I-V-E. This is your guy. This is your card. You want to change it? Do you want... What? F-I-V-E. F-I-V-E. You spell it F-I-V-E. So this is your card. Isn't that how you spell 5? All right. So we spell 5. All right. So this is your card. Now, if I would have counted it out, it would have been down here, but we're going to make it hard. Okay? We're making it hard on you. Now, I hope you got the right one. We're going to find out. So, you know you're the Bible. So, what card do you have? Yep. Money, 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 money. Tithe money. So, is giving your tithes, giving your money. It's important. It's important to give your tithes and your offerings. I mean, you give your tithes because that's just not stealing, but giving your offering, is that the key? Is that the key to Hakuna Matata? No, they said no. So you may have a seat, young lady. All right, very good, very good. All right, Miss Pat, let's see your card. Ooh, cards, lottery, gambling. That'll get you money sometimes, so it'll take some money away, but is that the key to Hakuna Matata? No, thank you. All right. Christina. The golden rule. Following the rules, doing what you're told, is that the key? Sorry. I still like you. I mean, they don't, but you go ahead. Pastor Eric, what do you got? The Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments are important, but is the Ten Commandments, what the Bible says, the key to Hakuna Matata, to no worries? No. Thanks for playing. No consolation prize for you. What do you got? Praying. Praying is so important, guys. Do it daily. Do it multiple times daily. We always tell the kids to give God at least 5 minutes in the morning, 5 in the afternoon, and 5 in the evening, minimum. Got to get up at 6 to go to school? Get up at 5:55, you know, just give God that time. It's like Simba did, man. Spent that moment with his father so he knew what to do. But prayer ain't the key. Wink. Sorry. Michelle, what do you got? Ooh, baptism. Baptism is important. It's a way to show people that you belong to Jesus, that you're buried with him and rose again. Baptism is necessary, man, after you accept Jesus. But is it the key? Is that what the Bible says, that the key to having no worries, no fears, and all that? Thank you. You may have a seat. Oh, Grace, what do you got? Being happy because I'm happy to be alone. If you feel like a room without a roof. I think my daughter and her boyfriend are watching, her fiance watching from home. They're going to just like really get me when I get home. So being happy, being joyful. And I said it's necessary to keep that balance, right? To let people see that you're happy to be a Christian, that, you know, you're happy that you have Jesus, right? But is that the key? Just smiling every day? That ain't the key. You know it's not the key. Sorry, Grace. Coming down to it. What do you got, young lady? Oh, the stars, astrology. I know a lot of people talk about their horoscopes and talk. They look and see what's going to happen today. And no judgment. I don't judge you. But looking to the stars ain't going to give you the answer. It's not. That's not the way. That's not how you have Hakuna Matata. It's not. You got the wrong card. I am so sorry. Man, your day's just ruined. I'm sorry. Okay, come over here, please. Stop looking at your card. Come over here. Okay, come up here. Dr. Bailey, come over here. Five. F-I-V-E. Let's see what happened. This is your card mentally. Are you ready? Turn your card around and let's see. Oh, it's Jesus! Chessman, good job. You picked the right number, the right card. Thank you, guys. All right. Jesus. Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father but through him. Jesus will give you peace. Jesus will give you joy. Jesus will give you Hakuna Matata. No worries. This is the answer. And if you don't know Jesus, if you've never accepted him, you need to. Because life is so much better. When you go through hardship, when you go through trials and tribulation, leaning on Jesus is so much better. It is so much better. It's so much comforting to know that I have a Father that cares about me. And even though I go through problems, I may have financial issues, I may have physical issues, life just dumps on me, I still will raise my hand. Like Job said, though the worms may devour my body or though I am slayed, I will still praise his name. So no matter what you're going through today, Jesus is the answer. Now I want to give you a moment. Praise God. I want to give you a moment here. If you bow your heads and close your eyes, and I want to give you a moment. If there's anybody in here today that has never accepted Jesus, but you feel that in your chest, you feel that you need to just accept Jesus as your Savior, I want to pray with you today, right where you're at. I'm not going to call you down here in front of the stage, but if there's anybody in here, I just want you to quickly put your hand up and put it down. If you've never accepted Jesus and you want to today. All right. Anybody else? Just raise your hand and put it down. I'm not going to call on you. I'm not going to embarrass you. But today's your day. This is it. This is the moment, man. This is the moment that's going to change your life. All right. Now, I want to pray as a congregation together. We're going to pray. And these two are going to receive Jesus as their Savior. So just repeat after me. Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you that you sent Jesus to save me from my sins. Right now, I ask that you forgive me of all the bad things I've done, all of the sins that I've committed. I am so sorry. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ died on a cross and rose from the dead and lives. I accept him into my life as my Lord and Savior. And I know right now, because I confess these things, I repented of my sins, that I am forgiven, I am saved, and I am set free. In Jesus' name, everybody say, amen. Amen. Give Jesus a hand clap. Amen.